Hi everyone, my name is Shawn Barry and I'm a graphic designer with over 30 years experience in the business, and this is my YouTube channel. It's all about learning graphic design, so join me on this journey. Okay, so for those of you who have seen the videos that I've created in the past, if you've just discovered my channel, please like and subscribe if you enjoy these videos. Hopefully you'll explore more of them because there's a lot of content and there's a lot more to come because I've undertaken a pretty large and possibly stupid project, but it was the only one that I could think of doing that was worth doing. So to back up, I've been telling my subscribers now, the 40 or so thousand that I have, that I'm all, by the way, very grateful for all of you that you sort of stuck around in some way. And if you're seeing this video, thank you again for your patience with me. So over the last couple of years, I've been talking about trying to resurrect my YouTube content, but I kept running into the same roadblocks. And the roadblocks were, I would begin thinking about a series and I might do a video here or there. I've done a couple. And then I would realize, okay, very soon I'm going to start repeating myself. If I just stay in the territory of doing these long form lectures where I do a design demonstration. And that was the idea, but then I would get into it. I would do a video, then I would start making ideas for the next ones and realizing I'm going to run into that problem again where I start repeating myself. And what I don't want to do is repeat myself. Even though the information that I have in those videos does get repeated, and by those videos I mean all of the videos that I've done up to this point, but the information comes back, but if I just re-describe it, it didn't seem to make as much sense. So then I would stop again and think, well, I've got to figure out how to do this. Then I thought about creating a website where I would have all of my courses. And that would create more premium courses, but it wouldn't be Skillshare, it wouldn't be Udemy, it would be my own website that I would charge people to take the courses. But then in doing that, I realized that while valid, and while I am qualified to do that, that it's very hard to make the case if you don't know me and you don't trust me, how am I going to ask you for possibly $100, give or take, to take some course that you really don't know if it's genuine or not. There are so many fake gurus, as the new term is, that I've heard recently. And so I didn't want to be one of those people. I'm not one of those people. I actually have the credentials and the actual knowledge to communicate actual design information. This is not about me trying to get clicks on YouTube. So I thought, well, I don't really want to take an audience that I'm trying to develop trust with and then send them to another website where they're going to pay me for a course, even though I want that money to support what I do, because this does take a ton of time. It's an enormous expenditure of effort to make these kinds of videos. So I thought, well, what am I gonna do then? If I can't do something that I can monetize very easily, well then I guess I can only do it on YouTube. But if I do it on YouTube, I'm kind of doing the same thing I was doing before. So what do I do with that? So I thought at one point, hey, I'll do some vlogs, but even those weren't really giving me new content ideas that I could really help somebody learn. And this is where I had possibly my dumbest idea of all, which I think is probably why it's going to work. I remembered that a lot of people who have reached out to me, the one thing that was common in many people's communications to me were, I'm trying to learn design, I can't really go to a design college, I don't have access to one or the money, so can you help me learn design? Can you do a video about this subject, a video about that subject? And when I thought about those things, I realized, well, those things themselves weren't necessarily material for a whole video. So what do I do with that information? And what do I do with the idea that most of the people who are reaching out to me are trying to learn how to do graphic design, but not just watch a Photoshop tutorial, because that doesn't help you much. So I thought, I know, I have a dumb idea. I'll just do a design course that may take me several years to complete, where it's just going to be one lesson after another, after another. So start there, and I will put up a new video every week or 2 weeks. It'll just depend on how much time I can dedicate to it, but I will put them up because now this is a clear path. So you can look at my YouTube channel and you will see lots of classic lectures. I'm not deleting those, they're still there. And there's a lot of good information in those videos, but maybe more relevant to people after they've done maybe several of the learning design videos where they start to understand some of these principles. And then those more advanced lectures will start to make more sense. Of course, time will kind of make them irrelevant. The design principles are there, but maybe the lessons won't be relevant. So I have to think about what to do with that. I don't know. But the point is that I'm going to do this learning design from scratch video series, which will replace the Design 101. I'll leave that up. Those lectures were good too, but they jumped too far ahead too fast. And so I decided that what I had to do was basically make each lesson with an assignment, put that up, and then develop the next one based on that and begin to grow through the process, the complexity of the lessons. But with all that said, I can basically unleash 35 years of knowledge into this YouTube series if I do it carefully enough, and I think doing the design from scratch approach will solve the problem I was having with the other video series. So that's where this video series has come from. And this video I'm just gonna put up and kind of let it hang there for a bit. But I'm also gonna create what I'm gonna call the Creative Director Advice Series. That's a bad term, but I don't know what I'll call it yet. But I'm going to do some lectures where I just talk about principles of design and put those up occasionally. That takes the pressure off trying to make those videos everything, because that was harder to do. So this way I can do one every once in a while when it feels good and when I have a subject that's relevant that I want to talk about. And that'll make more sense, and then the design learning from scratch videos can just kind of keep going every week or 2 weeks. And so that's what I decided to do. So this video is up to kind of let you know what I'm doing, why I kept making promises that I couldn't deliver on. I'm still here. I haven't gone anywhere. It's because I was wrestling with how to, you know, how to fulfill that promise. Anyway, click like and subscribe if you're not subscribed already. And I appreciate your time. You can watch a lot of other YouTube videos, but you're here watching mine and I appreciate that. And I'll never do a Photoshop tutorial. I'll never do an InDesign tutorial. I'll never waste your time with something you could Google and find out in 10 minutes. All my videos will all be about deeper knowledge and the real design why question. Not how do you do something, but why would you do something? That's my motivation. So thanks for your time. Thanks for watching. Like and subscribe, and I'll catch you in the next video.